reasons of this mission was to demonstrate the capacity of the A330neo to operate at high altitude airspeed. Now we demonstrate at Toluca, which is an airspeed above 8,000 feet, that the aircraft is capable of now. So it's part of the envelope destinations. We continue at La Paz, which is an airfield above 12,000 feet, to show the capacity of aircraft to operate takeoff and landing at such altitude, which was successful. During that mission, I was acting as a chief of missions. So my responsibility was first to prepare the missions in terms of crewing, engineering, planning. And then I cope with all the experts I have with me. We were more than 40 people during that mission. I also have the advantage to act as a test pilot during the mission as well. We were three test pilots. One of them, technical pilot, which is the expert on A313 on all subjects. We had also another test pilot just to support for us. We were also accompanied with three flight test engineers and two test flight engineers, which are all part of a crew.
So my role on this mission is to make sure that the aircraft configuration corresponds to the needs for this test in high altitude. Normal installation of the aircraft, standard calculators, and as well the flight test installation. All the equipment that are needed to acquire data and get the good numbers. I was also in charge of the flyaway kit, which is the spare parts for the aircraft itself and for the flight test installation as well. Specificities for the high altitude mission is mainly for the oxygen system, because aircraft is equipped with automatic drops of the mask as all the aircraft. So we have to take care that this doesn't occur during such a mission.
Voilà. Alex, ça va?
C'est bon, okay. Mon rôle durant la mission était donc de discuter avec Jean-Michel Pain, voir si à l'issue de chaque vol, il y avait des points d'essai qui n'étaient pas atteints, comment on s'organisait sur le reste de la semaine pour garder le planning qu'on s'était fixé avant le départ. Aussi, je me suis occupé de la mise en route des aérotraceurs pour qu'après, derrière, les maps spécialistes puissent faire en fait l'analyse de données, voir si sur certains types d'essais, on n'avait pas décelé des odeurs d'huile ou des odeurs de Pâques.
Mon rôle principalement est d'étudier et de préparer les plans de vol, d'obtenir les autorisations de chaque pays qu'on survole et également bien sûr obtenir le permis d'atterrissage au Mexique et en Bolivie. Avant le départ, la préparation est principalement administrative entre le crew, la maintenance, le handling et également les autorités locales. Arrivé sur place, nous avons plutôt un rôle logistique et bien sûr, on doit s'adapter à la météo par rapport aux essais demandés. Le problème de la haute altitude, c'est que le corps s'adapte à plus de 4000 mètres. On ne sait pas comment les gens vont réagir. Donc, il nous faut réserver des concentrateurs d'oxygène pour la mission.
During the campaign, my main task focuses on ground, where I review the test results from the flights. I communicate with the different design offices to see if the results are sufficient or if we need to adapt the test campaign plan or if we need to repeat some of the test points. Part of the preparation work for the mission is to define the required instrumentation on the aircraft. In this case, on the engine side, the instrumentation focused mainly on the starter air pressure measured during the testing, as ground starting is an important part of the campaign. Another specific instrumentation was the DGPS, which was a ground station installed on the ground.
DGPS is a name for GPS to providing an enhanced positioning capability. On the DGPS activity, we have two main goals. The first one is the preparation. We need to ensure the aircraft to be ready for all the tests to be done for the 2 or 3 weeks coming. Then after the campaign, we analyze the data. And we need to ensure that the computed data has enough accuracy for all the flight physics activities.
What we do normally is we analyze the execution and calculate the atmosphere conditions and the speeds. Normally, in telemetry, we're able to give direct feedback to the crew, and if there is a need for repetition, they can do it. But in this particular case, that was not possible. So we get the data from the people on the ground, and we analyzed it, and we were able to give them the feedback within the day, so that they can replan the tests that they want to do the next day, so that we have all the data that we require for certification.
Concerning the constraint to operate an aircraft at high altitude airports, technically, there are not so much. The main constraints are more on human side than on aircraft side. By extending the envelope of operation of the A330neo, which was successful, we can show now to the operator, the current one or the new ones, that this aircraft reach the same capacity as the A330-0 in terms of high-altitude operations, with the advantage that A330-neo is less consuming.